We're not done yet. When we introduced the iPhone in January, we said it was the best iPod ever. And iPhone owners agree with us. It is the best iPod ever. And people have been asking us and wondering, when are we going to bring this technology to an iPod? Well, the answer to that question is we're going to do it today, and this is what the product looks like. It's called the iPod Touch. I happen to have one right here.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to another review video on some nostalgic tech again. I did recently post a video on the iPhone 3GS, and I know you guys probably saw in the background there was this little puppy perched up against the iMac. I am in fact talking about the first generation iPod Touch, as you've just seen there in the first video. Again, probably not many differences in between the iPhone first gen and 3GS that we've just recently done, but it's also good to have a look at it and just kind of see where it came from. And I guess in some ways it's very nostalgic to some, because this would have been the first iOS device that many people actually owned, myself included. I had an iPod Touch second gen way before I even had an iPhone. The iPhone 6S was my first phone from the iPhone line. So again, for affordability, people looked at these, and this was the first one that they released. So yeah, before I get into it guys, just to remind you, there is a giveaway going on my channel. If you've recently seen the video posted, I am giving away, celebrate the new year and to celebrate the start of this channel, I'm giving away a Razer Siren Mini microphone. It's really easy guys, the video is on my channel if you want to take a look, but all you've got to do is you've got to enter the link that's on the description for the video. You've just got to view my YouTube channel, that'll give you one entry, and then you can view my Instagram page, that will give you another entry as well. You're not required to subscribe, you're not required to follow. If you do, that's amazing, I really appreciate it, and I really appreciate you even checking it out. But yeah, just thought I'd let you know guys, give you that little reminder. The giveaway is still active, and you've got till 6 p.m. GMT UK time on the 1st of February to enter, and the Razer Siren microphone could be yours to win. So that's that guys. Anyway, let's get into it. So yep, the iPod Touch first gen, very similar in terms of looks. I picked this up on a used it was a used game shop actually in the UK called CEX. If you're from the UK, you guys will know where I'm talking about, but I basically wanted the first one just because I had a friend actually who owned one of these before I had the second. So this was my first ever, like, basically experience of an iOS device over everything else, over any other iPhone. This was the first one I actually used. So I remember, I think it was 2007 when it was released, so it was September time, because I know the iPhone was released in January, and these guys basically revised the iPhone model and made an affordable one for people, essentially the iPod. The better way of saying it is really that I think a lot of people and consumers wanted a touchscreen iPod, which is why we have them now. So yeah, it ran for another year till the following September 2008, when it was discontinued and the iPod Touch second gen, I should say, was then released, following more incremental in changes with different iPod devices, etc, etc. This one, it ran a ARM Samsung system on a chip. It was actually a Samsung one from what I read. It was a 400 to 412 megahertz chip. It wasn't really that rapid, but by today's standards, obviously, with what we've got in the newer phones, it's not going to seem that quick. But back in the day, it did what it needed to do, and even now, it still holds its own. It boots up fairly quickly. I have a few apps on there, as you can see, similar to what I have on the 3GS. Tap, Peggle. And they all run fine. I'm not going to demonstrate them, guys. I don't have any audio, because the iPod Touch has no inbuilt sound. But yeah, it will be a similar kind of experience, similar kind of screen size. They do run nicely, and they always were quite fun to play back in the day for me. They also came in 8GB, 16 or 32GB flash memory options. I think this one, I believe, is the 16. Yes, as you can see. Condition wise, it isn't the greatest. I mean, these are scratch magnets on the back, they always were, but ultimately it is nice. I do favour the old aluminium exposed like chrome backing sides that Apple had. It is very classy, and this kind of like black grey kind of moulded edge. Again, another gorgeous device, incredibly thin. I think it weighed in at around 4 ounces or 115 grams depending on which system you buy. Really light, and again for your pocket, perfect size. Teamed with your headphones, which were included because you've got the headphone port on the bottom. They were the same headphones that we saw in the iPhone 3GS. Brilliant set of headphones, great listening experience. It had a 3-axis gyro, a 3-axis accelerometer, so you could enjoy all the same apps as the iPhone of the time with that movement and that kind of shaking around. So you've got the lighter. I'll show you that. There you go, see, so you can see it works just like the iPhone does. Yeah, it gave them all the experiences and the same fun and like intuitive design as an iPhone, but without the cost of a contract, etc. Really great selling point, really great marketing move by Apple. One thing we are looking at is the screen. So this was an LED backlit. It was a TFT LCD display. I think the resolution was around 480 by 320 pixels at a pixel density of 165 pixels per inch. So not the most amazing screen, obviously, again, by what we know today, but I mean, I'm looking at it now from a distance. It might not pick it on my camera. It still looks really beautiful, even now. Like, it's clear. It's not extremely pixelated. You can differentiate the pixels if you look at it closely. But the screen itself, for the time, I mean, you got to think we were competing with a lot of, like, Philips, Sony, I think a couple of Walkmans were still kicking about. Philips, like, MP3 players that had similar touchscreen kind of, like, esque screens, but they weren't up to par with the multi-touch on the iOS devices of the time. Big marks for that, I guess, for the first generation of the iPod. It really did sell well for them, and obviously it had Wi-Fi, so you could enjoy all the same great App Store and iTunes Store that the iOS featured. It ran iOS 1.1, so it was a very early firmware. It'll have been the same firmware as the first gen iPhone. And I believe it ran up to the iPhone OS 3.1.3 till around 2010, and I think that was the last firmware for this device for around then. So, and then finally, guys, I guess the reason I actually purchased this, I have got no box for it. It came just as is, and it came with a cable. These iPod Touches, first gens, they came with a Wolfson DAC sound chip. Now, if you're quite nerdy and you know your iOS devices and the iPod Classics, etc., essentially the Wolfson DAC provided a much richer, warmer sound profile. If you compare it to like the second gen, the fourth gen, fifth gen, etc., you can see a notable difference in the actual sound quality. The songs and music, and even just your content, if you're playing like music or even videos, I've got Monsters Inc. on there. I've probably put some music on. There is a big difference in the sound quality. I've even had it in the car, because my car is an aux cable, so I was just kind of trialing the iPod for old time's sake, see what it was like in the vehicle, and it came through brilliantly. It came through very loud. It was very similar to that of my my new iPhone 12 that I have now. It sounded high quality, sound powerful. I don't know the full details of that, if it is just a special sort of sound chip, but I do believe the iPod Classic 5th gen or 5th and a half gen, 5.5, does share the same chip, and I have had one of them. I actually recently sold one of them from a collection. I wish I kept it. It had the same Wolfson DAC sound chip on board, and it did deliver a really impressive sound profile with music. So, yeah, another great reason to kind of get one of these devices. If you're an audiophile, there's nothing wrong with putting your music on here and using it as an everyday driver. Again, similar to the iPhone, you're going to have limitations with the current apps now. So your weather app, it probably won't load because it's using the old extinct Yahoo weather services. So it's not going to show that. You do get mail. I don't know if this works. I haven't checked if it works. See, that's my email. It doesn't get the mail, so confirms that. Contacts, obviously it can't make calls, so that'll just be contacts synced from your iPhone or iTunes. The YouTube app, sadly missed. I don't believe it works anymore. If I go on featured, it might actually load. Don't hold me on that. It might load some of the devices, some of the videos. Yeah, no. It's not coming through, so really did miss that app. It was a nice integrated app, and I do miss the icon. So it's nice to see that actually crop up. Yeah, the iTunes Store, I think it does still function on the iPod. I don't think it differs from the iPhones. It's on the latest firmware for its device. It should still be able to fetch artists and music for sale. Okay, maybe not. Yeah, it's crashed. Yeah, so this is running 3.1.3, which is the latest firmware, and I believe it's probably not going to be able to find anything. So if I go on featured, it's probably not going to be able to find it. Yeah, sadly not, guys. So that's another feature that doesn't work on this device. But again, it's 2007, it's 2 years older than the 3GS we've just reviewed, so we're not going to expect great things from that, sadly. Again, the App Store, it could potentially be working. I think it did. So what I do know about this is it will display current apps. Obviously these are just top free apps from this country. It'll show you obviously KFC, Tesco. These won't download, guys, so you'll probably be able to get as far as tapping on one, and it will display the app's information, but if it was to click get, it'll probably ask for a password. But it's not going to be able to install, guys, because the firmware is way too outdated. Yeah, I won't even go through that, but I can guarantee you it does list everything. It does show the actual apps, but in terms of usability, it won't, because the firmware that's required is way ahead of what it's currently running. So again, sad, but you can still kind of access it. I'm sure featured works, so you can browse on it, but it renders useless because you can't actually purchase anything. The only thing I believe you might be able to do is if you manage to find a menu for your purchased items, because on the iPhone you can go down to updates and then purchased, but it doesn't show it on here. So the only way, and this is a tip from me, the only way you're going to be able to get your apps back onto your iPod Touch first gen, if you've had one or owned one in the past, if you have an iTunes media library on your desktop or a hard drive from years back and it stores all of your iTunes files, I think you can rummage inside there and there will be the original apps as an IPA format. So there will be Peggle.ipa, which is iPod application, Jellycar.ipa, and it's a case of you can drag them into the iPod Touch onto iTunes. If you're on a newer Mac, if you plug this into the computer, it will recognize it. It does it in the Finder now. Obviously iTunes is no longer an app, it's just the music app. So if you're wanting to sync anything to this, it displays it on the Finder section of your Mac. It shows it up as the iPod Touch still. And you can just drag and drop manually, guys. You can put your music in there if it was purchased on your iPhone or iPod in your account. And it will put your stuff back on there. It's just you've got to find a bit of a way to get it on. But again, if you're one of these that likes to jailbreak your device, there's nothing stopping you with doing that. This device has been jailbroken numerous times, I'm presuming. Not this one, but this device as a whole. You can get it to be jailbroken and get all your apps free, if that's what you want to do. The options are there. But yeah, it's nice to have in my collection, guys. I don't currently use it. I probably might put it in my car the odd times if I just want to have a flick through my old library, but ultimately for me, it's just a bit of a collector's piece. I do have it on my desk next to the iPhone, and it does bring back kind of the start of the whole generation of mobile gaming, because really ultimately it was the iPod Touch that kind of kick-started that mobile gaming kind of precedent amongst people. Kids started buying these for Christmas or birthdays, etc., or getting them for Christmas and birthdays, and they were able to experience all the same great applications you could find. So yeah, a really nice piece of nostalgic tech. I'm guessing you guys have got your own stories or memories of owning the first iPod Touch, and what games you played, etc. But yeah, for me, I didn't own this, but I experienced it. A friend of mine, he used to get the latest of everything. It was a joy to experience that first kind of Apple touchscreen magic, as Steve Jobs described. So that's it, guys. That's the iPod Touch first generation. Not much more different, again, than the 3DS or even the first gen. Hopefully I can get a first gen to have a look at and I find a decent one, but that might be for another day. It's been great having a look at it, guys. Thank you very much for sticking by me for another cosy little nostalgic trip down memory lane. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a good evening, guys. I'll see you in the next video, and look after yourselves. Take care.